The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, second chapter, text number 46 through 62, given by His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on December 16, 1968, in Los Angeles.
Served by a small pond, can one be served by the great reservoirs of water? Similarly, all the purposes of the Vedas can be served to one who knows the purpose behind them. 47. You have a right to...
Now, try to understand this. The long-standing system in India, in the villages, India is originally village-like, city-like, very few. Perhaps there was only big city, New Delhi now. In those days, Hastinapur, and next to that was Dwarka. So, very big city, and there are only two or three. Mostly people used to live in villages. Still, 90% population of India is in the village. So, in the village, the system is, there are different kinds of wells. One well is meant for taking bath. One well is meant for washing clothes. One well is meant for taking drinking water. One well is meant for washing dishes. In this way, in the villages, there shall be a half a dozen wells. So here the example is given, just like one can take service from a particular type of well for a particular purpose. But if he goes to the river, ever-flowing river, then he can take his bath there, he can wash clothes, he can wash dishes, he can... everything, all water purposes will be served in one river. Because the water is flowing there. There is no contamination. Any water which is always flowing, there cannot be any contamination. Stagnant water, which is not flowing, there may be contamination. Therefore, the restriction is that you should take bath in this well, you take wash your clothing in this well. So, small wells, they are restricted for a certain purpose. But in the river, there is no restriction. Everything can be done there. So, Bhagavad Gita, you'll find in the 15th chapter, the Lord says, Vedaisya sarvai ahameva vidyam. The purpose of all scriptures and Vedas is to know Krishna or God. So, and the Upanishad says, Jasmin vijñāte sarvameva vijñātam bhavanti. If you simply understand the Supreme Absolute, then you understand everything. So, this Krishna consciousness means it includes everything. The karmis, activities, creative actions, the jnanis, philosophers, speculation, the yogis, mystic power, and bhaktas, devotees, worship of the Lord, everything is included. Just like if you have got a millions of dollars, then $10 is there, $5 is there, $20 is there, everything is there. So if you take to Krishna consciousness, then you take all kinds of, all the well, all the purpose of different type of well is served in the river of Krishna consciousness. That example, he said, it includes everything. Just like Krishna consciousness, we are, take practical example, we are Krishna conscious. Now, take any religion and take their highest conclusion, it is there in Krishna consciousness. Take for example, Buddhism. They say non-violence. Oh, we are non-violent. Christianism, love of God. We are simply meant for loving God. Christian, Mohammedan, servant of God, to render service to the Lord. You are 24 hours engaged in the service of the Lord. Yogi, samadhi, always in samadhi, absorbed in the thought of the Supreme. We are always absorbed in the thought of Krishna. So take any religion, any process, any well, there is this river, Krishna consciousness will overflow everywhere. There cannot be any comparison. How much water is there in the well? In the river, unlimited. Thousands of wells can be merged into the river. This example. Jasmin vijnati sarvameva vijnatam bhavanti. If you know Krishna, you know everything. You know science, you know mathematics, you know philosophy, you know geography, everything. There is no dearth of knowledge. Don't think that a Krishna conscious person, actually, he can be a foolish man. No. That is given guarantee in the Bhagavad Gita. Tesam evanukam pārtham mahamajñāna jantamaha nāśayātniyāto bhāvasya jñāna dīpīna bhāstata. A devotee who is always in Krishna consciousness, for him there is nothing unknown. He knows everything. Just like we can give information of the whole creation, not only of this material world, of the spiritual world. Clear conception. Where is where? What is what? Everything. That is Krishna consciousness. The more you make progress, then you fully, conversant with all departmental knowledge. Everything is complete.
You have a right to perform your prescribed duty, but you are not entitled to the fruits of action. Neither consider yourself the cause of action, nor should you be attached to inaction. Purport. There are three considerations here: prescribed duty, capricious work, and inaction. Prescribed duties mean activity in terms of one's position in the modes of material nature. Capricious work means actions without the sanction of authority. And inaction means not performing one's prescribed duty. The Lord advised that Arjuna not be inactive, but that he be active in his duty without being attached to the result. One who is attached to the result of his work is also the cause of the action. Thus he is the enjoyer or sufferer of the result of such action. As far as prescribed duties are concerned, they can be fitted into three subdivisions: routine work, emergency work, and desired activity. Routine work, in terms of the scriptural injunction, is done without desire for results. As one has to do it, obligatory work is action in the modes of goodness. Work with results becomes the cause of bondage, and so such work is not auspicious. Everyone has his proprietary right in regard to his duty. but should act without attachment to the result. Thus, such disinterested obligatory duty can lead one to the path of liberation. Arjuna was advised by the Lord to fight as a matter of duty without attachment to the result. If non-participation in the battle is another side of attachment, such attachment never leads one to the path of salvation. Any attachment, positive or negative, is cause for bondage. Inaction is sinful. Therefore, fighting as a matter of duty was the only auspicious path to salvation for Arjuna. 48. Be steadfast in your duty, O Arjuna, and abandon all attachment to success or failure. Such evenness of mind is called yoga.
This is the explanation of yoga. Evenness of mind. Yoga samattam chate. If you work for Krishna, then there is no cause of lamentation or jubilation. Jubilation is there because you are working for Krishna. But there is no cause of lamentation. Yoga sakkur karmani. Yoga karma sukausala. That is the secret of activities. How you can very diligently work at the same time you are not entangled with the act. That is the secret.
49. O Dhananjaya, rid yourself of all fruitless activity by devotional service, and surrender fully to that consciousness. Those who want to enjoy the fruits of their work are misers. 50. A man engaged in devotional service rids himself of both good and bad actions.
Now here it is, one significant word is there. One who wants to enjoy the result of his work, he is miser. What is the opposite word of miser? What is the opposite word? Liver. Is it not? So those who are in Krishna consciousness, they are liberal. And those who are acting for his own benefit, they are miser. They are Mahatmas who are working for Krishna. That is also stated in the Bhagavad Gita, Mahatma. Mahatmanusmangkartha Devi Prakriti Vasti. Sva Mahatma Sudullava. Bahunam Janmanamanti Gyanavanvang Prapadvate Vasudeva Sarvamiti Sva Mahatma Sudullava. After many, many births, when a person is actually wise, Gyanavan, perfectly in knowledge, what is that symptom of perfect knowledge? Vasudeva Sarvamiti. Krishna is everything. That is perfect. Vasudeva Sarvamiti is papadate mam. And if I find out somebody supreme, then it is my duty to surrender unto him. Yes. But as soon as I surrender, I become Mahatma, liberal, not miser. Miser is thinking on his own account. How much I will get? How much in my share? And liberal means he has no more share. Everything Krishna owns. This is Krishna consciousness. Sva Mahatma Sudullava. That sort of Mahatma, liberal person is very rare. So Krishna consciousness a person in Krishna consciousness, you cannot find many. It is not possible. Everyone is miser. He is always thinking, how much share is mine? How much I can collect for my personal? And Krishna conscious person is simply trying how much he is giving to Krishna. This way. One this way, one this way. This is miser and liver. Everyone, in all principles, they go to God for asking something. That is also described in the Bhagavad Gita. Artho Arthyati, Jnani Jignasu. Four kinds of people go to God. Those who are distressed, of course they are fast. Anyone who goes to God, never mind, even for asking daily bread, they are pious. But those who are not going to God, they are impious, miscreant. One who is thinking, why shall I go to God for asking bread? I can produce my bread. That man who is very proud of producing his bread is a nonsense miscreant. And a man who is going to the church praying, God, give my daily bread, is pious. But he is not a pure devotee. But there is chance of his becoming pure devotee in future. So artho arthati jigyasu. So the Krishna consciousness is nothing to ask from Krishna. Oh, Krishna, give us our daily bread. No. It is far, far higher. Because he knows that Krishna, I ask and no, I do not ask. Krishna is supplying me bread. He is supplying bread to the beasts, birds, and animals, insects, and I have sacrificed my life for Krishna, and he will not supply me bread. Is it very intelligent? No. He knows perfectly well that Krishna is taking care of me. Now, it is my duty how much service I can render to Krishna. That is my duty. That is Krishna consciousness. Krishna is not miser. He is supplying millions and millions of living entities bread. So what is the use of asking him? Without asking. The birds, the beasts, they have no choice and pray to God, oh, give us our daily bread. But nobody is starving. Nobody is starving. Eka bhunam vidadati kama. That one supreme is supplying everyone's necessities. Either you go to church or don't go to church. Krishna is so kind. He's supplying toward everyone. Therefore, one who is in the higher standard of consciousness, he will think only that Krishna is supplying so much for us, what I am doing for Krishna, that is Krishna consciousness. That is Krishna, that is intelligence, that is Mahatma, that is liberal, he begins to become a liberal. So long one is not in Krishna consciousness, he is miser. Simply thinking, how much bread I have got. Miser means, another sense of miser is, one who cannot utilize money properly. Suppose one has got $1 million from his father, but he is simply thinking that I shall see the money and I shall not utilize it. If I go to utilize, I may lose it. The better I will see every day in my treasury box. He is also miser. Similarly, this human form of life simply used for the sense gratification is miser. he cannot utilize this form of body for increasing the asset of Krishna consciousness. Therefore, he is miser. And one who is properly utilizing this valuable life for understanding Krishna is Brahmin. Brahma janati iti brahmana. Brahmana means one who knows the Supreme Absolute Truth. He is called Brahman. The sacred thread is offered to a person who knows Krishna. Otherwise it is not awarded. This is a symbolic representation. This man has got sacred thread, that means he knows Krishna, Brahma, Supreme Brahma, just like Arjuna. Parabrahma, Paramadhama, Pavitram, Paramam, Bhavam. And in the 10th chapter you will find, Arjuna says that you are Parabrahma. Krishna, you are Parabrahma. Similarly, if anyone knows Brahma, Parabrahma, Krishna, he is Brahmin. Brahma janati iti Brahma. One who knows the Supreme Brahma, Krishna, he is Brahma. Not a person who is born in the family of a Brahmin. He may be a chandala by his mentality. So, Bhagavad says, jasahiga lakhanam sha varnabhi banjakam. There are symptoms. You'll find all these things in Bhagavad Gita. Who is Brahmin, who is Kshatriya, who is Vaishya, who is Sudra, by symptoms, by characteristics, you will know. Similarly, if you find a man knows Krishna, you must accept him, he is a Brahmin. He is a Brahmin. Brahma janati iti brahmana. So, the miser, the opposite word is liberal or Brahman. Miser knows his self-interest. How much nice foodstuff I have got to eat daily, that's all. And liberal, how much Krishna prasadam I am distributing to the world. Liberal. A miser is thinking, how much nice dishes I have eaten today. How much I have satisfied my tongue. Never mind, I go to hell. Let me eat these bad dogs. Only nice. Let me satisfy my tongue. For your tongue, so many animals have been sacrificed, killed. Never mind, I want to satisfy my tongue. Miser. But Krishna conscious person, he does not satisfy his tongue. He wants to satisfy Krishna. And whatever remnants, foodstuff is there, he eats. He is liberal. These are the distinctions between miser and liver.
A man engaged in devotional service rids himself of both good and bad actions, even in this life. Therefore, strive for this yoga, O Arjuna, which is the art of all work. 51. The wise, engaged in devotional service, take refuge in the Lord and free themselves from the cycle of birth and death by renouncing the fruits of action in the material world.
Yes. Are there purpose?
No, there's a little more to that slope.
Finish.
In this way, they can attain that state beyond all misery.
Read it again.
The wise engage in devotional service, take refuge in the Lord, and free themselves from the cycle of birth and death by renouncing the fruits of action in the material world. in this way to come to peace, in this way that can attain that state beyond all misery.
So how easy it is. You take to Krishna consciousness, you act in Krishna consciousness, you overcome the cycle of birth and death. And as soon as you overcome the cycle of birth and death, you overcome all miseries. Because birth and death means this material body. The living entity, spirit soul, has no birth and death. And anyone who possesses this material body has to undergo the threefold miseries of the material world. A similar passage is there in the Srimad Bhagavatam. The other day, as I was speaking to you, Nunam Pramatta Kurute Bhikarma. All these people, they are acting in a way which they ought not have to have done. Nunam Pramatta, but they are acting as madmen. Why? Just Indriya Pritaye, for satisfaction of the sense. Nunang pramatta kuruti vikarma jadindriya pritaye aprinoti na sadhu manne. This is not good. Because he does not know that he has achieved this material body by working in that way in his previous life. Again he is working in that way. So he'll have to accept again this material body. Therefore he's miser. He's not properly blessed.
When your intelligence has passed out of the dim spark of delusion, you will become indifferent to all that has been heard and all that is to be heard. There are many good examples in the lives of the great devotees of the Lord, of those who became indifferent to the rituals of the Vedas simply by devotional service to the Lord. When a person actually understands Krishna and one's relationship with Krishna, one naturally becomes completely indifferent to the rituals of fruitive activity, even though he may be experienced Brahman. Sri Madhavendra Puri, a great devotee and a charger in the line of devotees, said, "O Lord, in my prayers three times a day, all glory to you. O bathing, I offer my obeisances unto you. O demigods, O forefathers, please excuse me for my inability to offer you my respects. Now, wherever I sit, I am able to remember the great descendants of the Yadu dynasty, Krishna, the enemy of conflict, and therefore I can get myself free from all sinful bondage. I think this is sufficient for me."
This is a prayer by Madhavendra Puri. He says that I'm not going to do anything except serving Krishna. This Madhavendra Puri was the grand spiritual master of Lord Chaitanya. Madhavendra Puri's disciple, Ishwar Puri. And Ishwar Puri was accepted as spiritual master of Lord Chaitanya. Nobody can become a spiritual master of the Supreme Lord, but in order to teach us that even the Lord, he also accepted a spiritual master. That is the system. Mahajana Dhinagatasya Pantha, unless he shows us the way, people will say, "Oh, Lord Chaitanya did not accept any spiritual master." They can give example. But therefore, Krishna also accepted spiritual master. This is a system. One has to. Tadvijnanathum sa guru meva avigachyat. One must accept a spiritual master if he at all wants to know the spiritual science. Without that, it is not possible. Krishna science, Krishna consciousness cannot be developed without the assistance of a bona fide representative of Krishna. Nisangmati stavadurukramam. There are very, very many, many instances. what is that? Wrong.
The Vedic rites and rituals are imperative for the beginning of human life.
Yes. Dharmena hina pasuhi sama. Vedic rituals. Every human society has got some scriptures and some ritualistic activities. Never mind whether Hindu, Muslim, Christian, Jews, they have. That is the symptom of human civilization. If you have no religion, if you have no standing, then you are animal. In our mind you accept this religion or that religion, it doesn't matter. But you must have a religion. Otherwise, a man is animal. Well,
comprehending all kinds of prayer 3 times a day, taking a bath early in the morning, offering respect to the forefathers, it says, but when one is fully in Krishna consciousness and is engaged in his transcendental loving service, one becomes indifferent to all these regulative principles because he has already attained perfection of life. If one can reach the platform of understanding by service of the Supreme Lord Krishna, he has no longer the duty to execute the different types of penances and sacrifices recommended in revealed scriptures.
Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, when he started this movement, he preached that simply by chanting you will get all perfection. And the Brahmins of Navadvip, they rebelled against him. That this boy, he was a boy of 20 years or something, less than that. This boy is preaching something against the Vedic religious system. So, in other words, they were afraid of their priestly profession. Because if everyone takes to simply chanting Hare Krishna and forgets all ritualistic activities, then how they will live? They were priestly class, they were getting some money by their followers. So, but Chaitanya Mahaprabhu had no such desire. He simplified the whole thing. Harinama iva kevala. Simply chant Hare Krishna and you become elevated to the highest platform. Actually, it is so. You can see from the behavior of our students, they simply took this chanting. Now see their behavior, see their character. It will automatically. That is the result. Yahaite sarvasiddhi hai vetvan. Lord Chaitanya said, all kinds of perfection will follow. Simply you begin chanting Hare Krishna sincerely.
And similarly, if one has not understood that the purpose of the Vedas is to reach Krishna and simply engages in the ritual, then he is uselessly wasting time in such engagement. Persons in Krishna consciousness transcend the limits of Sabda Brahma.
Sabda Brahma. Sound by this. Sound Brahma. Brahma in sound. Sound just like Brahma means all pervading. All pervading. So this sound is all pervading. You will find sound beginning from the sky to the earth. You will find sound all pervading. And in the sky there is sound, you have got an experience. In the fire there is sound. In the air there is sound, in the earth there is sound, every metal, wood, everything, there is sound. So Brahma means all pervading. But this transcendental sound, just like your radio message, television sound, they cannot go beyond this earth with planet, at most. But there is sound which can penetrate the whole universe and go to the spiritual world. Sound is all pervading, there is a fact, scientific fact. Now if that sound is potent, then it can penetrate even this material sky and go to the spiritual sky and go to Krishna directly. That sound is Hare Krishna. Golokera premadhana harinama sankita ratina janimila marata. I've given that, he has translated in a five week. Golokera premadhana. This is descended from the spiritual platform, Golok Vrindavan, harinama sankita, this is Hare Krishna. Ratina janimila marata. I have no attachment for this thing. I have got attachment for radio sound, for television sound, so many sounds. But I have no attachment for the supreme sound which is coming down from the Goloka Vrindavan. Golokera prema dhana harinama sankirtana ratina janminama visaya visanale divanisi hiyajana. In this material world, my heart is always burning on account of so many miseries. Taribare na kainu paaye, but I could not find out the way how to get out of it. This sound vibration will get you out from the blazing fire of this material condition. This sound. Hare Nama, Hare Nama, Hare Nama, Yukshuvara. Chant, all it, everything will be perfectly done. Yes.
Persons in Krishna consciousness transcend the limits of Sattva Bhama or the range of the Vedas and the Upanishads. 53. When your mind is no longer disturbed by the flowery language of the Vedas, and when it remains fixed in the trance of self-realization, then you will have attained the divine consciousness. 54. Arjuna said, what are the symptoms of one whose consciousness is thus merged in transcendence? How does he speak, and what is his language? How does he sit, and how does he walk?
This is very important. One, the symptom, the characteristics of Krishna conscious persons, they are described there, item mind.
The blessed God said, O Father, when a man gives up all...
This is the result of talks between Arjuna and Krishna. Arjuna is putting in such a way and Krishna is answering. That means it is meant for all conditioned souls. Unless Arjuna would have asked all these questions, how we could have received such transcendental message? Therefore, it was necessary that Arjuna would play the part of an ordinary conditioned soul. Actually, he was not. He is simply playing the part in order to eschew transcendental message. Because Krishna has spoken, everyone will take it as upright. So Krishna is now speaking. Go on.
The Blessed Lord said, O Father, when a man gives up all varieties of sense desires which arise of invention, and when his mind finds satisfaction in himself alone, then he is said to be a pure transcendental consciousness.
Now, if one comes to the understanding, enlightenment, this is the beginning of enlightenment. Self-understand that I am part and parcel of Krishna. I do not belong to this material world. I am not part and parcel of this country, this world, or this material atmosphere, but I am part and parcel of the Supreme. This is a lack. Read it again.
The Blessed Lord said, O Father, when a man gives up all variety to stand in
God. If you are interested with so many varieties, material varieties, suppose I belong to this country, then I have got so much duties, so many duties. If I belong to this world, if I belong to the human society, if I belong to this and that. But if you simply belong to Krishna, that is enlightenment.
Yes. When his mind finds satisfaction in himself alone, then he is said to be in pure transcendental consciousness. 56. One who is not disturbed in spite of the threefold miseries, who is not elated when there is happiness, and who is free from attachment, fear and anger, is called a stage of steady mind.
Now, if I do not identify myself with this body, if this knowledge is fixed up, then the miserable condition of this material world is due to this body. But if I don't identify with this body, then what relationship I have got with all this misery? This is theoretical knowledge, of course, but one has to practice. But this is a fact. Just like, for the time being, if there is any pain in the body, I feel pain because I am absorbed in this bodily concept of life. But actually, I am not this body, that is a fact. It is due to my absorption of bodily concept of life, therefore I feel. The more I become enlightened, the more I shall not be affected by all these miseries.
The word Muni means one who can agitate his mind in various ways for mental speculation without coming to a factual conclusion.
The mental speculators are called Muni. There are so many Munis.
It is said that every Muni has a different angle of vision, and unless one Muni is different in view from another, he cannot be called a Muni in the strict sense of the term. But a Sthitadhyaya Muni, the kind mentioned herein by the Lord, is different from an ordinary Muni. The Sthitadhyaya Muni is always in Krishna consciousness, for he has finished all his business with creative speculation. He is called Prasanta Nisita Manorata Manorakantaram, the one who has surpassed the stage of mental speculation and has come to the conclusion that Lord Sri Krishna, Bhakti Deva, is everything. He is called Muni, fixed in mind. Such a fully Krishna conscious person is not at all disturbed by the onslaught of the threefold misery, those due to nature, to other beings, and to the frailties of one's own body. Such a Muni accepts all misery at the mercy of the Lord, thinking himself only worthy of more trouble due to his past misdeeds, and sees that his miseries, by the grace of the Lord, are minimized to the lowest. Similarly, when he is happy, he gives credit to the Lord, thinking himself unworthy of that happiness. He realizes that it is due only to the Lord's grace that he is such a comfortable condition, and thus able to render better service to the Lord. And for the service of the Lord, he is always...
You must say, when there is misery, a Krishna conscious person takes the responsibility himself. And when there is happiness, it is due to Krishna. But the materialistic person is just the opposite. When he is in misery, he will say, oh, God has put me into such misery. And when he is happiness, he says, oh, you are now well-to-do. Yes, you do not know how much I have worked hard. When he is happiness, he takes the credit for himself. And when he is in distress, he gives this credit to Krishna. Krishna has put me to such misery. But a Krishna conscious person, when he is in distress, he'll say, yes, due to my misdeeds, I should have suffered 100 times more than this distress. But Krishna is so kind, he has given me little, that's all. And when his happiness, it is all given by Krishna. Therefore, all the opulence should be utilized for Krishna's service. This is the difference. He is asking, Arjuna is asking, what are the symptoms of Krishna conscious person? Sitapragna. Sitapragna means steadfast in intelligence. So these are the difference. I read one speech, Chicago speech by late Vivekananda Swami. He's talking to the audience that you work so hard, why you give credit to God? If you find his Chicago speech, he'll say.
And for the service of the Lord, he is always daring and active, and is not influenced by attachment or detachment. Attachment means accepting things for one's own sense gratification, and detachment is the absence of such sensual attachment. But one sits in Krishna consciousness has neither attachment nor detachment, because his life is dedicated in the service of the Lord. Consequently, he is not at all angry, even when his attempts are unsuccessful. A Krishna-conscious person is always steady in his determination. 57. He who is without affection, either for good or evil, is firmly fixed in perfect knowledge. 4. There is always some upheaval in the material world which may be good or evil. One who is not agitated by such material upheaval, who is without affection for the good or evil, is to be understood as fixed in Krishna consciousness. As long as one is in the material world, there is always the possibility of good and evil, because this world is full of dualities. But one who is fixed in Krishna consciousness is not affected by good and evil, because he is simply concerned with Krishna, who is all good, absolute. Such consciousness in Krishna situates one in the perfect transcendental position called, technically, samadhi. 58. One who is able to withdraw his senses from sense objects, as the tortoise draws his limbs within the shell, it should be understood as truly situated in knowledge. 59. The embodied soul may be restricted from sense enjoyment, though the taste of sense objects remains. But ceasing such engagement by experiencing a higher taste, he is fixed in consciousness. 60. The senses are so strong and impetuous, O Arjuna, that they forcibly carry away the mind, even of a man of discrimination who is endeavoring to control them. 61. One who restrains his senses and fixes his consciousness upon me is known as a man of steady intelligence.
This is the conclusion of all symptoms. There are others also?
One more.
Oh, yes, read it.
62. While contemplating the objects of the senses, a person develops a passion for them. And from such attachment, love develops, and from love, anger arises.
Let's stop there. Okay. So, if there is any question, we can discuss.
There is a question about the stupid. And Marge said, the stupid is, I can't be sure. First one is, if you say, give me lot of the money for Krishna, are you a miser?
Yes, see, Pastor know who is my dad and he is Levi. Do you know that? Yes. If you want money for Krishna, then you are not my dad. Just like you are working for this temple and you ask Tamal Krishna, Prabhu, please give me $100 I have to spend for this purpose. Is that bad? Yes. He not only accepted spiritual master, but he took all the risk to go into the jungle to bring wood for the spiritual master. Pure load. One day it so happened the whole day they were in the forest and Sudama Vipra and he, they both of them were entrapped. There was heavy rain. They could not come out and the whole night they remained within the forest. So, not that because he was Krishna, he did not accept any spiritual master work on him. He took so much risk. He went to the forest. Otherwise, who will accept spiritual master if he does not show us the way? He comes to teach us. Jada jada hi dhanvasya glani bhavati. When there is discrepancies in the discharge of Vedic rules and abhuthana vadhanvasa and irreligious principles are too much rampant, then I appear very stated. So he teaches us how to acquire knowledge, how to behave. That is Krishna, the purpose of his mission. He does not act any way which will be followed by somebody and he'll go to hell. No. Yes. Yes. Why shall I not? Yes. Pain was there, but it was not too much. The boys, the disciples were chanting, I was chanting, so there was not so much. It was not so much painful. That is already explained. When there is distress, the devotee takes it that I am suffering for my past deeds, but I should have died at this moment, but Krishna is simply giving me little pain, that's it. That was actually that was the thing that day I should have the heart attack was very severe. I should have died. Nobody survived such heart attack. But Krishna saved me. That's all.
Are you in this world?
I am not in this world. Yes. No. Yes.
I thought you said that you are in this world without being a part of it.
Eh?
you are in the world without being caught up in like the lotus flower which flows from the water.
Yes, that is the way. That is the way of understanding. Just like I'm in America. It is very easy to understand. I'm not adopting any ways of life as the Americans do. So I'm not in America. And not only myself, all my disciples who are following me, they are also not Americans. They're different from American behavior, American ways of life. In that sense, I'm not in America. I'm in Vrindavan. Because wherever I go, in my apartment or in my temple, I live with Krishna and Krishna consciousness. I don't accept any consciousness of America. And I teach my disciples also to take to that consciousness. So one who takes to that consciousness, he is also not in America, not in this world. It is that I have given this example in many times, just like a king and a bug is sitting on the same throne. The bug is biting and the king is ruling. It is not that because the bug is there on the throne, he is king. Or the king is sitting with the bug, he is bug. Why this difference? Difference of consciousness. The king knows his duty, he is working in his duty, that he is king. And the bug knows his business to bite, that he is bug. But sitting on the same place. But because due to different consciousness, one is bug, one is king. If you take to Krishna consciousness, and if you remain in Krishna consciousness, you don't belong to this world. You are no more bug, you are king. Change this consciousness. Even apparently, you may seem to remain with the bug. You are no more bug. Is it clear?
What's the difference? I've heard terms about incarnation, expansion, primary expansion, and Krishna incarnating himself, expanding himself.
Yes. They say a person is in family his father, in office his boss, and in some other place he's something else, but the same man. But because we are materially conditioned, when I'm in the office, I'm not in my home. While I am acting as boss in my office, I cannot act as father with children at home. I am absent. This is due to my material condition. But Krishna, being full spiritual, he can remain in his abode, Goloka Vrindavan. At the same time, he can remain everywhere. That is expanded. Just like Krishna is living within your heart. Ishara sarva-bhutanam viddesho arjuna tishtati. The Supreme Lord is staying in everyone's heart. In the Brahma Sangita it is said as goloka-eva-nivasati-akhila-agnat-bhuta. This is spiritual position. That even though he is in his abode permanently, he can remain in everyone's heart, all over the creation. Not only in the heart, but within every atom also. This is his expansion, plenary expansion. He expands. We are also his expansion. we living entities, we are also his expense. Nothing exists without being Krishna. That is explained in the 9th chapter. Maya tatamidam sarvam. I have expanded in all different atmospheres. Sarvam. Masani sarvabhutan. Everything existing in me. Nahamati suavastita. But I am not there. I'm not there. You are existing in Krishna. But unless you have Krishna consciousness, Krishna is not in you. But you are existing in Krishna. You cannot exist without Krishna. So therefore, Krishna is everywhere, Krishna is in everything. We have to develop that consciousness. That will make me happy. Yes. When you become Bija, twice born, yes. Twice born means you come to the point of understanding Krishna consciousness. And when you take your birth from your parents, your consciousness is different. Just like the child, his consciousness is different. But when he's grown up, if he takes to knowledge, if he tries to understand Krishna, his consciousness is different. So when one takes to Krishna consciousness, that is the beginning of his second birth. Bija. Yes, if you take to Krishna consciousness, then there is no more reaction of your karma.
I also
think
that if we are a servant to someone, we can use the present to return to venerable service.
Well, you must be in service somebody if it is in Krishna consciousness. You cannot create your service independently. Then your service has no reaction. Jagyatya karma natru kayam karma bandhana. Krishna consciousness means you have no more any personal activity. Person, because your person is also related to Krishna. How you can act personally? You have to simply act in Krishna consciousness. That is dedication. That is surrender.